dugsiga boarding kaya maalinlaha ah ee Amano. Amano boarding and
our week 4 lesson. So today we are going to look at coastal flooding, and this is under the coastal environments topic. So first, let's begin by looking at the lesson objectives. So the first objective is to explain the meaning of flooding, look at causes and the impact of coastal flooding, and also explain ways of reducing coastal flooding. So I'd want us to move to the next and just start straight away and look at the meaning of coastal flooding. So coastal flooding happens when seawater overflows into the land. So seawater moving into dry and low-lying land. So the extent of coastal flooding is usually determined or controlled by the elevation inland. So if we have a flat elevation with the seawater, then that means if the seawater rises, then there will be an overflow. But for a steep elevation, even if this is the basin, even if it rises, there will be no flooding. So it is basically controlled by the elevation inland. Next, we look at the causes. So let's see some of the causes of flooding. So the first cause is storm surges. The second one, tsunamis. And the third one is climate change. So let's look at the first one, which is storm surges. So a storm surge is increase in water surface elevation. That means the surface of water is elevated up or is raised up above the normal tide level. That is because of low barometric pressure, and also the piling of waters in the coastal areas, and this happens because of the wind action over a stretch of land. So storms, they normally produce very strong winds that push the water towards the shore. So this one can lead to flooding, and this makes storm surges very dangerous for coastal regions. So a storm surge will happen when this is the surface of water, and because of the difference in wind pressure, a certain area will have low pressure. So the pressure being exerted here is higher than the pressure being exerted here. So that will force this part of the water to rise. And because of the strong winds, then it will be blown towards the shore. And that is what causes the storm surge. So I want us to look at the pictorial display of what happens. So we end up with this storm surge. So we'll have this area where there's low pressure. Then it rises up. So this part will rise up. That is what forms a hurricane, which normally destroys. And because of the wind blowing, there's a lot of strong wind blowing, it pushes that water inland towards the land. So that is how it ends up reaching the part of the land, destroying property and developments along the beach. So this sanction or the pooling is because of the low pressure in what we call the eye. Is the eye of the hurricane. So it will force water to rise up. So that hurricane, the cyclone or the storm surge causes storm surge will cause hurricanes and typhoons, which basically mean the same thing. They are a form of tropical cyclone. So a tropical cyclone is normally a term that is used by meteorologists to describe rotating. That rotation is because of water rising and wind blowing. So rotating organized system of clouds and thunderstorms that originates over tropical or subtropical waters. That's what we call hurricanes and typhoons. So hurricanes, typhoons, those are all forms of a storm surge. And the storm surge is also called a tropical cyclone. So that's an image, satellite image of a cyclone, which shows how the rotation takes place. And this is called the eye of the storm. So this eye of the storm is pushed because of wind pressure. It is pushed inwards towards the land. So that is how a storm surge is formed. And those are some forms of the cyclone, tropical cyclone, typhoon, and hurricane. Those are alternative names for a storm surge. So let's see the second one, tsunamis. So tsunami is a Japanese word meaning harbor wave. So it's a wave that reaches the harbor. So a tsunami is long high sea wave, which is normally produced by a disturbance. So if there's a disturbance on the ocean floor, the disturbance is caused by either volcanic eruption, an earthquake, or if there's a coastal landslide, that will form disturbance on the ocean floor. So that disturbance will cause displacement of water. So in other words, water will be pushed up. So that pushing up of water, for example, if the ocean floor is raised at once, then it will force water to form a spiral movement. So that spiral movement forms a tsunami which flows towards the land. So this could be as a result of an earthquake, could be an earthquake, or maybe as a result of a volcano, a volcanic eruption. So that will cause the tsunamis to happen. So this is an illustration. That's an illustration of a tsunami. So this is the material from volcanic eruption or a landslide, which causes elevation. So that means there's displacement of water. So the water will start flowing in waves, very big waves, flowing towards the land. This is another illustration of how a tsunami is formed. So we get an elevation here because of a disruption on the floor, and that causes the wave-like, very big wave coming towards the land. Now all this will be covered during the tsunami. The last one is climate change. So climate change usually leads to flooding, increased coastal flooding, also increased tides, very high tides happening. And this is because of the expansion of the ocean happens because of warming. So when water is warmed up, it expands. And also when there's global warming, it leads to melting of ice into the oceans, and that drives the level of the ocean up. So because of that, flooding will become even more common, because there's global warming is a continuous process, and unless an intervention is made, so it makes water to expand, and that means it overfills the basin. Therefore, there's a chance that it can move out of the basin of the ocean towards the land. So this happens because of the constant emission of greenhouse gases. That happens because of the lifestyle that we have nowadays. There's a lot of industries operating, a lot of cars on the road. So that leads to emission of greenhouse gases, which will trap the escape of carbon dioxide, and that leads to the global warming. So climate change is the third cause of coastal flooding. So let's briefly look at the impact of coastal flooding. So when coastal flooding takes place, it leads to loss of lives. People die, especially if the tsunami, the Japanese tsunami that took place, killed so many people. It also leads to loss of homes. People lose their homes. They lose businesses located along the coastal line. And it also destroys the infrastructure, such as roads, railways, and industrial plants that are located along the coastal line. So coastal flooding also has a potential to cause very massive social and economic cost. After the tsunami, the Japanese tsunami incident, the economy of Japan slowed down tremendously. So how can we reduce the coastal flooding risk? So to reduce the coastal flooding risk, we can use prediction. That means we try to look back at the historic records and we identify areas that have been flooded before. So that means we define the high risk areas. Also, it requires accurate forecasting so that there can be the possible hazardous events can be detected before, so can be cyclones and earthquakes. So it's not only detecting, but also their magnitude, the effect they will have. The next way of reducing coastal flooding is prevention. So by building flood defenses, for example, building a wall, high wall to prevent the water flooding, building emergency shelter centers in case there's a cyclone coming or hurricane coming, people can move there. Removing housing from high-risk areas, and also installing an advanced warning system, and also educating people on what to do when the warning is sounded. Usually most areas that are prone to cyclones or tsunamis, they have an advanced warning system which will alert them. And then people need to know what to do in case that system goes off. So to summarize our lesson, we looked at the causes of coastal flooding. We looked at three causes, which is a storm surge, which is caused by also called typhoons, hurricanes, tropical cyclones, is caused by variation in wind pressure. Tsunamis, which is caused by earthquakes, landslides, or volcanic eruption. And also climate change. This is due to global warming that causes the sea level to rise, and also the melting of ice, filling more water into the ocean. We also looked at the impact of coastal flooding. We saw that coastal flooding can cause loss of lives, can cause loss of homes, loss of roads, and destruction of industries as well. Then we also looked at how to reduce coastal flooding, and we looked at two ways: prediction and prevention. So prediction is about forecasting the occurrence of the phenomenon, maybe storm surge or a tsunami. Prevention is about building, like building the blocks, moving people away when it happens, and also relocating houses or buildings that are made along the coastal line. So basically, that's what we covered in our lesson